The following essay never made it into the original video called INFJ Seen Through the Eyes of a Clinical Psychologist. Certain things were deleted from the original essay because it was extremely long. Basically, a novella. That was not my original intention. First off, I am a clinical psychologist with 30 years of experience dealing with people. I am not a Myers-Briggs type indicator expert. I can only approach people identified as possessing a INFJ personality in accordance with human behaviorism and cognitive thinking. Although personality testing serves a purpose, it's one of several tools utilized by professional therapists to accurately determine a patient's overall mental welfare. The Myers-Briggs type indicator provides a brief snapshot into your overall personality. Personality exams and psychological exams are two entirely different animals. Imagine a cake. The frosting represents your personality while inside of the cake represents your psychological construct. That being stated, I find some INFJ stereotypes rather funny. And will approach such in a humorous fashion. INFJs possess a wonderfully unique sense of humor and will immediately recognize the silly stereotypes others have placed upon them. So let's begin. Many historical people throughout history have been identified as possessing INFJ characteristics. Some of these include Martin Luther King, Plato, Aristophanes, Dante Alighieri, Leo Tolstoy, Gandhi, Taylor Swift, and Adolf Hitler. You might want to forget that last person. He was a Fruit Loop. According to the Myers-Briggs personal test, only 1% of 7.7 billion people on Earth are INFJs. Moreover, certain personality characteristics of this type have many subgroups. Some of which overlap other MBTI personalities. In short, no two INFJs are the same. When a INFJ gives people the dreaded death stare, they are not attempting to understand you. They are wondering if you're carrying a gun. Killing INFJs is a pleasurable experience. Why? Everyone hates a smart ass. INFJs frequently experience sensory overload issues. They love forests, parks, and woodland areas to recharge their batteries. Why? Because trees don't talk. A squirrel cannot complain it has daddy issues. And I have never seen a bunny rabbit strung out on crack cocaine. Solitude is bliss. Never say to an INFJ, "I do not understand." They will run away screaming or jump in front of a bus. No one understands them. INFJs sometimes don't even understand themselves. Why do INFJs door slam people? Because it's a coping mechanism. INFJs dislike being emotionally hurt. There is nothing strange about this behavior. Everyone deals with stress differently. Some people become alcoholics, others pill poppers. A INFJ will simply walk away and pretend you never existed. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. INFJs have the psychic ability to absorb people's emotions. No. This phenomenon is called transference. If you continuously talk about your problems, an INFJ will unconsciously adopt some aspects of your emotional state. INFJs think outside the box. They live outside the box. They have never actually seen the box. What does it look like? Does it contain groceries? Are INFJs arrogant, cold, and distant around people? Yes. Being omnipotent has certain drawbacks. INFJs are logical thinkers. They often develop interpersonal relationships with people similar to themselves. They also avoid large groups of people. Why? Because human beings are weird, unpredictable, and dangerous. INFJs have a difficult time sugarcoating the truth. Brutal honesty is their trademark. This behavior is occasionally misinterpreted as being either egocentric or mildly offensive. However, if an INFJ senses someone cannot handle the truth, they will intentionally lie, attempting to protect that individual's emotions. Never ask a male INFJ the following questions. Do I look fat in this dress? What are you thinking? Or I need your unbiased opinion. They will immediately fall silent, unable to speak. Like someone having a brain stroke. INFJs make terrible boyfriends. INFJs think too deeply. They want to solve everyone's problems. They get frustrated when people ask for advice. Then completely ignore their recommendations. They do not understand why everyone keeps making the same mistakes over and over again. Eventually, INFJ will simply give up. The phrase "people need to learn the hard way" was invented by INFJ. Imagine it's the year 1912. You're on the Titanic. A large iceberg is approaching. An INFJ is jumping around hysterical trying to warn everyone the ship is about to sink. The passengers just laugh and continue drinking their champagne. Welcome to the wonderful world of INFJ, where everyone listens but no one takes their advice. During the zombie apocalypse, an INFJ will be eaten alive, saying, "I told you so. I told you so." INFJs do not respect authority because they have developed their own moral, ethical, spiritual, and cognitive belief systems. Mature, older INFJs care very little about how people perceive them, and less about the impressions they make upon others. INFJs enjoy approval and acceptance like everyone else, but infrequently compromise their principles to simply to fit in. Aliens will not abduct an INFJ. There are some things too weird for even extraterrestrials. Sometimes an INFJ will be misdiagnosed as possessing a narcissistic personality disorder. There is only one problem with this clinical evaluation. A narcissist loves adoration and praise. A typically INFJ doesn't seek the approval of anyone. Why? Because everyone else is wrong. Do INFJs have a profound wisdom about life? Yes. All INFJs morph into Buddha around the age of 30. When they reach the age of "I don't give a crap," they automatically blink out of existence and transcend to a higher form of spiritual consciousness. Probably somewhere in Florida. Who knows? What is the difference between a TCBY and INFJ? One is a ice cream sundae, the other a lunatic. That is a joke. Not a factual statement. Relax. They told me to spice up these video essays. I have nothing against Norman Bates or ice cream industry. Do some INFJs have a superiority complex? Yes. The solution for breaking this psychological disorder is quite easily. Make them watch emotionally intense movies like Me Before You or Field of Dreams. If they start crying, job accomplished. Do INFJs hate their personality type? Yes. They feel alone within the world and misunderstood. They dislike thinking differently from the rest of society. Life isn't much fun when an INFJ understands how everything is going to end. Imagine Sherlock Holmes on methamphetamines. All INFJs experience one of these problems throughout their life. Depression, anxiety disorders, or avoidant behavior issues. What you see is what you get meeting an INFJ. They typically do not have any hidden agendas or covert plans. Unless they are identified as a dark INFJ. No one really wants to encounter a dark INFJ. They will use everything within their psychological arsenal to manipulate or disable people for self-serving purposes. Sometimes for entertainment. It's an ego thing. Fortunately, most INFJs are extremely compassionate and enlightened souls. INFJs have an incredible insight into human nature. An INFJ can determine your intentions or motives within seconds. Literally. Never lie to an INFJ. They are walking polygraph machines. INFJs understand more about people than themselves. Avoiding getting into heated arguments with an INFJ unless you are prepared to be intellectually, emotionally, or psychologically castrated. You cannot win an argument with these people. They have cognitive resources almost beyond understanding. An INFJ will not go ballistic unless directly threatened or cornered. Most INFJs are pacifists. Fortunately, INFJs give up rather easily during an argument. This is where the door slam or simply walking away from a conversation comes from. If an INFJ loves you, be prepared for lengthy romantic rituals. Boxes of candy, flowers, poems, lovely e-cards, teddy bears and such. But be careful. An INFJ understands how to manipulate situations to their advantage. But not with malicious intentions. If you become their vision quest, INFJ will stop at nothing until you fall in love with them. They can charm the apples off a tree. Once an INFJ reveals their inner nature, you will begin to understand why only 1% of the world's population are INFJs. The stereotypes disappear very quickly. These are people you want within your life. They truly understand what they term unconditional love and compassion means. INFJs infrequently go on casual dates. They are not really interested one-night flings with the opposite sex. They are always searching for their soulmate. That perfect love. Unfortunately, INFJs have a difficult time maintaining long-term relationships. Why? Because they don't understand true love does not exist. It's a fantasy. True love comes from effort, patience, time, and understanding. Furthermore, it requires the abandonment of certain beliefs for new ideas. Compromise. Some INFJs cannot cross that bridge. Failed romantic relationship takes a large portion of INFJ's spiritual existence. They will give up on themselves long before giving upon you. When an INFJ says, "I don't need someone to complete my life, I complete myself," they are essentially saying they surrender. Enough is enough. The game is over. They will disappear quickly and never be heard from again. If an INFJ does return to a relationship, they are probably seeking revenge. Why? Because someone tested INFJ's personal integrity and self-worth. Principles they hold very dear to their heart never attempted to manipulate, change, or alter an INFJ's core personality. They possess hyper-observant cognition and know instantly what someone is attempting. INFJs rarely take pride in their accomplishments and frequently scorn flattery and praise. Yes. This humility comes from being a perfectionist. INFJs are their own worst critic. They enjoy accomplishing great things but believe they ultimately failed in the end, even when they succeeded. INFJs dislike small talk, unimportant conversations, and superficial trends. There is only one path in life. Abandoning idle nonsense. If you place two INFJs within the same room, both will spontaneously explode. No. INFJs are not human firecrackers. They just get bewildered meeting people similar to themselves. What happens when two INFJs door slam one another? Have you ever heard of a cosmic event called a black hole before? INFJs are not spontaneous. They just pretend to be spontaneous. Their minds are always attempting to connect the dots, even when there are no dots. INFJs invented running sneakers long before the discovery of fire 40,000 years ago. Why? To escape from life-threatening situations often requires good footwear. INFJs did not survive 7 million years of human evolution without taking some precautions. They can outrun a walker on steroids. INFJs have no interest in taking selfie pictures of themselves every 30 minutes. They already know what they look like. Vanity doesn't interest an INFJ. Avoid getting into intellectual conversations with an INFJ. They are walking encyclopedias. They will jump from topic to topic then back again to support an idea or theory. Male INFJs are scattered brained in the worst way possible. However, there is method to such madness. They are searching for the correct answer to a specific problem. And 95% of the time they will discover it. Or will have a complete nervous breakdown trying. Occasionally, you will notice them acting rather mysterious, doing unusual things, or just behaving odd. Get used to this behavior. It has absolutely nothing to do with you. The INFJ is just going through a stage or experimenting with something that interests them. Like building a thermonuclear bomb or discovering a cure for herpes. INFJs are not social butterflies, however, once you get them talking, they never shut up. Do not open this Pandora's box. In 1841, writer Thomas Carlyle wrote a book attempting to explain what heroism means. What exactly is a hero? INFJs have been compared to Batman, the Dark Knight, or Mother Teresa. They will defend people who cannot defend themselves. Speak for people who cannot speak for themselves. They will stand up and confront evil face to face, saying, "This far and no further." Are INFJs heroes? No. Everyone is capable of such courage. INFJs may be introverts but enjoy extroverted pleasures. Some INFJs enjoy purchasing very expensive things. They only want the very best. In general, INFJs disapprove of materialism. But they have no problem buying a beautiful $1,200 Gucci purse or $30,000 Rolex wallet. They are terrible at money management. Best advice? Hide your Visa card immediately after watching this video. INFJs are deep thinkers. They occasionally find it difficult to verbalize a thought or idea into spoken words. Either that or they're completely drunk. Middle-aged INFJ women have been there and done that. They understand men are replaceable. Often with a pint of Ben and Jerry's ice cream or Krispy Kreme donut. Male INFJs are sometimes oblivious to dangerous or lethal situations. This is not bravery. It's called stupidity. If a tornado is approaching, you don't move closer trying to get a better look. If a INFJ encounters a wild grizzly bear and wants to pet it, stop them. Bears are not dogs. They will attack anyone who agitates them. Going skinny dipping in a lake full of piranha fish is a really bad idea. Please protect INFJs from themselves. Anyone. INFJs are not a touchy-feely people. If you want to confuse a INFJ, give them a hug. They will immediately develop an existential crisis. Never ask an INFJ what they want for their birthday or Christmas. They sincerely do not care. INFJs are more concerned about the fate of the universe than receiving a Hickory Farms gift basket or pair of SpongeBob underwear. Aliens will never abduct a INFJ. There are some things too bizarre even for extraterrestrials. According to some esoteric theories, INFJs are probably alien-human hybrids. Almost all INFJs complain they do not feel entirely human. They feel lost amongst a crowd of strangers. They occasionally say they want to go home, and home isn't Earth. I have absolutely no comment on this theory whatsoever. I'm a clinical psychologist, not UFO researcher. Being abducted, rectal probed, and examined by extraterrestrials falls outside my area of expertise. INFJs are the fail-safe button of last resort. When everything falls apart, they step up. INFJs are the unwitting and reluctant heroes in a storybook. Normal people forced into extraordinary situations. Again and again. Similar to a character trapped inside a Shakespeare tragedy. INFJs can't escape the pages of the book no matter how hard they try. Fate has other plans for them. INFJs are absolutely terrified of reincarnation. They're aware that neither heaven or hell wants them. Why? Because God cannot deal with the extra competition on who should run the universe. Him or a INFJ. And Satan doesn't want an INFJ pestering him for all eternity. That would be considered cruel and unusual punishment. INFJs are frequently stereotyped as possessing old souls. Yes. They have recyclable souls similar to a crushed beer can. When Adam and Eve were thrown out of the Garden of Eden, INFJ snuck inside and stole the remaining forbidden fruits from the Tree of Knowledge. Why? Because INFJs really enjoy a good apple pie. I think they invented Pop-Tarts too. People with green eyes represent 2% of the world's population. INFJs represent 1% of the world's population. If you ever encounter an INFJ with green eyes, you're the luckiest person alive. Buy a lottery ticket immediately. You're on a winning streak. The most interesting aspect of the INFJ personality is the most ironic. They are good people. They understand their brains were hardwired since birth to think, behave, and interpret information differently. The greatest gift a INFJ can give you is seeing the world through their eyes. But who helps a INFJ when they have a problem? No one. Why? Because most people can't relate themselves to this personality type. Most INFJs understand this situation and frequently assume the role of a lone wolf. They subconsciously separate themselves from society. In nature, a lone wolf doesn't survive very long on its own. Why? Because wolves are socially oriented animals. Humans are no different. INFJs frequently need time out or simply being left alone for extended periods of time. They prefer their own company than that others' people. Never play guilt games with a INFJ. They frequently persecute themselves from being different from the rest of society. Lastly, INFJs are often stereotyped as having a curse. This stereotype only works if a INFJ believes it. What is the INFJ curse? It's having a deep insight into human nature but not understanding themselves. The irony is they sympathize humanity yet cannot save themselves. Thank you for being with us to the end. You can be anywhere in the world now and you chose to stay with us, we truly appreciate it.